Hello everyone. I hope you're an FPM aspirant, that is why you are here. I am Priyam Kukreja from Chandigarh and I applied to various IIMs for PhD admission this year and I got interview calls from some of them. I appeared for 4 interviews and I was able to convert 3 of them. I am Kozhikode, I am Lucknow and I am Indore. I would be joining IIM Indore this year in the area of organizational behavior and human resource management. So firstly, I'll tell you about my profile and then we'll proceed. I'm a commerce graduate with the Bachelor of Commerce and with management honors, and then I did MCOM honors in finance from University Business School, Punjab University. I actually started with my PhD with the University Business School in the area of human resource management, and I was in my coursework when I applied to various IIMs. That means yes, you can switch from some state or central university to IIMs for some obvious reasons, and I did so. So if you have any query in that, I switched from Punjab University to IIMs. Coming to the preparation part, the preparation begins even before filling out the application form, because the application forms would require statement of purpose and research proposal, and those require work well in time, well beforehand, and the various videos for preparation of research proposal and statement of purpose are uploaded here on this channel as well, and I'm sure they'll be of great help to you. Once you have applied, once you have the interview calls, you keep preparing for the interviews meanwhile, right? So firstly, we have some generic questions. Like in any corporate interview, they ask you, describe yourself, tell me about yourself, then what are you up to these days, and how do you see yourself in the coming 5 to 10 years, what is your short term and long term goal. These are generic questions and these are expected, so don't think that you'll answer these questions 100% organic way, because a clarity of thoughts is required and you want that the answer should not come out in a haphazard way. So have something in mind, so think of something that you speak so that the clarity of mind is reflected in the answer and you are able to develop some kind of rapport with the interviewers. Then we have motivation based questions. See, PhD is an extensive program. It is a rigorous one in IIMs where you have to put in so much of, you have to invest so much of time, energy and efforts. I'm sure you must be having some genuine reason to pursue PhD, right? So then you have your reasons, put them in a nice answer, frame one, see how it will be pleasing to the interviewers. Then the second is, why this domain? Like, I had my post graduation in finance, mm-hmm. I had finance honors, so why I wanted to switch to HR and OB? Why I wanted to switch from Punjab University to IIMs? The answers have to be pleasing to the interviewer and they have to be genuine. Please do not fake those answers, because you don't know when in the interview those answers would work against you. So please be honest and try to think of the interview as a formal conversation. That would not be stressful to you, as well as you will be able to put out the best of yourself, right? Then after those motivation based questions, those also include why this particular IIM, why not the other one, to which all other IIMs have you applied, have you converted any of them, why do you think you have not converted any of them, or why have you not converted that particular IIM, right? Then coming to the next part is the basics of your domain, is the basics of your subject. Like if I'm applying for OB and HRM, I'm expected to go through their basics. I am expected to know the terminology used and the theories, the main theories, the main contributions in the domain. So I refer to Stephen Robbins for organizational behavior and Gary Disler for human resource management. This channel also has a video on the recommendations on the reading part, so that will also be of good help. After those, see, in OB, it it is very important that you know the motivation theories, the leadership theories. They'll ask you to critically evaluate any of the theory. They can ask you anything, but all you can do is whatever is under the sky, you just go and prepare as much as you can, right? So for OB, Stephen Robbins is a very nice book, very nice book. It has almost all the content in it and very much clarity is there. And for HRM, we have Gary Dessler, as I just said. So after the basics part comes your SOP or your research proposal. See, you are proposing something. You take it as your topic. You take it as something that you have created, you want to build on. So you have to be very clear about the background of, like, if I proposed on something related to organizational justice, I am expected to know the theories of organizational justice, the major contributions in organizational justice. And if you do not have the clarity, they would be not very impressed, as in, why do you want to work on it when you yourself are not very clear, right? So you should have the clarity of every word that you have used in your SOP. If they have asked you for a research proposal, you have to have clear knowledge on what you are proposing. How will you, what will be their methodology that you'll apply, and how is the sample to be collected? What are the managerial implications of your research? How your research is going to help, whom it is going to help, and how it is going to help? So you should know these questions. After that, we have statistics. The basics of statistics are to be known. Central tendency, mean, median, mode, then you have kurtosis, skewness, normality, the normality curve, and the distributions that you have. So the basics are to be revised. They may ask you any of these statistics. Like in one interview, they asked me, how are you in statistics? So you can score yourself on the basis of a 10 mark scale, right? I said I was 5.5 on that. So although they are not going to ask you questions on each and every topic, but it when you have read something, you are confident about it, and the confidence shows, and that is what helps you to go smoothly in the interview, right? Or else you will always be in a fear ki ye na pooch le, wo na pooch le, ki aise na kare, hai na? So then we have, after statistics, the research part, the research methodology part, very, very important. You need to know the basics of quantitative as well as qualitative research. Yes, they do not expect you to know everything of research, because that is why the coursework is here. We'll learn everything there. But you need to know the basics, what quantitative research designs are, what qualitative research designs are. And since I was already a PhD candidate at Punjab University, they expected more out of me. They expected me to know various research designs and how is one different from the other. The types of probability sampling, non-probability sampling, and all these questions. So this is mainly what I like to say, that firstly the motivation questions should be prepared, then related to your domain, the basics, third the stats part, and fourth the research part. So once you have prepared these many things till the interview, I cannot guarantee you that yes, they are going to ask you these questions only or from these topics only, but you will be well prepared for the interview. You will be confident and you may be able to take those questions. Even if you don't know some, you will be confident to say that I'm not very sure of this, or I'm not very comfortable with this topic. So this is the basic thing. You can also contact me on LinkedIn if you like to know anything more about it. I've just tried to summarize this, and I thank Yusuf sir for helping and guiding me, because this entire process I was helped by him, and I've prepared according to his guidelines. So thank you very much, and I hope this video is of help to you.